top of clouds.
Well, hello everyone, welcome. I'm Katie and this is a Fountain Pen Awakening. I hope you're doing well wherever you are in the world. Here today in sunny Queensland, it's hot as Hades, and so I'm filming inside. I've got a fan going, the AC going. Today is not as bad. The past 3 days have been super humid, but today's kind of sort of like a cool breeze is blowing, so it's a little bit better. They keep telling us that we're getting storms and rain, but yeah, we haven't had that yet. So today is my day off. It's Monday, and so I thought that I'd just show you quickly those ink samples that I got with my last haul, the one that when I got my Platinum Plaisir, and that video I concentrated on the Platinum Plaisir, and then, you know, I said that I was going to do a quick swatching with you. So today I was playing around with my inks and trying to find a cute way to swatch my inks, because, you know, it gives you an idea of what the ink really looks like. But also then I've done my writing samples with my pens, because I've actually got these inks inked up, because, you know, when I bought these inks, it was quite some time ago, and I am ink curious, so I've got to see what they look like in my pens. Just a disclaimer about my Platinum Plaisir: it's not that it's an awful pen or anything like that. It's not that I'm not going to keep it in my collection. It was just one of those pens where it was a bit of an underwhelm, because so far in my pen journey, most of my pens, the majority of my pens that I've bought, have been a pleasant discovery. And so it's not that I'm hating on the Platinum Plaisir or a Preppy. I just don't find the writing experience super exciting. I sort of like, now that I try that out, that nib is very similar to my Pelican Twist. They both have the mediums, and I just don't find them nibs super exciting in them pens. As a matter of fact, my Pelican Twist is uninked, and I just like the aesthetic of it, and I'm happy for them to be in my collection. But I just find myself reaching for other pens, which I enjoy the writing experience more. So, you know, I am new to this, everyone. I'm no expert. I'm just sharing my journey with you guys, and just it's my personal opinion, and I don't want sort of people thinking that, you know, I'm hating on any pens. I'm not even someone who reviews pens. I'm just coming on and sharing with you guys what I'm discovering along the way. So I thank you all for commenting, for liking, for subscribing. I'm loving the way we're all interacting and we're getting to know each other. I have some people who are actually in Australia now that have started following my channel, which is great. And also, you know, I interact mostly with you guys over in the States and with Canada. However, you know, there's a few channels here, Australian content creators, and you know, it's just great to be able to get to know you all, you know. So again, I just have to thank you for participating in my journey. So I just wanted to sort of do that disclaimer. All right, so as you can see here, these are the inks that I got in my last haul. So I got a couple of Wearangeul inks, and sorry because I keep spelling it wrong, but it's actually, this is the right spelling. And the Wearangeul inks I got from the Desk Bandit. They have a lot of different inks, especially Asian inks. So this is from the Philippines, and the Troublemaker ink is from South Korea. So I really love the I Am Cat, and it's sort of a gray, but it's sort of a greeny gray, and it sort of dries kind of like a greeny gray with this beautiful sparkly warkly bits in it. Now this is inked in my Twisby Mini, the 1.1 stop. This obviously goes without saying, it's a shimmer ink, as you can see. This one here is the Song of Reed. I also really love the names that they give their inks, and this is kind of like a sand, I call it a sand color, but it's kind of a beigey, yellowy, sandy color, I guess. Or light brown, I don't know what you would call this, but it's quite a neutral color, which I enjoy. This is inked in my Pilot Metropolitan in my Goldie with my calligraphy medium nib. This is another Troublemaker ink. It's the Moon River, and I find it, you know, when you do the sample of it, it's sort of quite dark, but when you write with it, it sort of tends to be quite light and a little bit dry as well. So this was the ink that I tried in my Platinum Plaisir, but what happened was when I first inked it up with the cartridge that it came, it wrote really well. And then when I rinsed it out and tried writing with this, it was really hard. I was struggling and it was really pale. And one of the people who commented on that video said to me that the Platinum Plaisir does, like the feed is full of water and it's there for ages. So the idea is to actually make it dry out really well before trying to ink it up again. So now I've put it in my Lamy Vista or the italic nib. But yeah, so it's an all right ink. I mean, I don't mind it, but yeah, it's a bit dry, so I'm not kind of super excited about that one. Then this one here is the copper patina, so, or patina. Now with this ink, I did buy a sample originally and I absolutely loved it. And so then I had to buy myself a bottle of it. So I thought I'd just sort of share this one with you. And I love it. I love it in my skull kill. It's just such gorgeous ink. The only thing about it is, you know, you've got to shake it around a fair bit for it to get that gold in it, because it kind of like tends to, after a while, it just tends to sort of write that turquoise color and not have that many sparkles in it. This other ink that I was really wanting to try was the Robert Oster ink, the Sydney Darling Harbour, and I absolutely love this color. This color is like a sagey gray green, which I love me a sagey green, or you know, like a green that's got more gray in it or more lavender in it. And I don't really like the bright greens, you know, like the apple greens and the, you know, two brighter greens. I like me kind of this smoky color, kind of gets me. And I don't know if you can see it, but it does have some kind of lavender shading in there. But when you write with it, it kind of writes, you know, this sort of pale. And I've got that in my new Lamy, the All-Star, the blue-green one with a fine nib. And I actually must admit that I'm really enjoying the way this fine nib writes, because it does have a lot of shading in it. So this pairing here, I'm really enjoying. So these, so 1, 2, 3, 4. So the 1, 2, 3, 4 were my sample inks that I got to try out. That is my bottled ink that I bought that came with these samples. And then I thought I'd just chuck in, I've had this for a while, the sample of this, and I bought myself a bottle of it because I just love it. And I love it because it's kind of like a dark green, but it's got sort of, you know, these purple blue shimmer in it, and it writes for a shimmer ink, it writes super super well. It was really smooth. I haven't got any problems. I had it originally in my Twisby Mini, and then when I got my Moon Man, I bought the bottle of it, and now I've paired it in my Moon Man, and I absolutely love this ink. So the BO, what that means is it is a broad oblique. That's what the nib I have on my Moon Man. So yeah, super super nice. And I had fun. So now practically finished my MCATs. I finished the Moon River. I've still got a little bit of the Song of Reed, and I've still got a little bit of this Robert Oster Sydney Darling Harbour left over. So I've done pretty well, because I kind of like using up my samples. I don't want them sitting around too long. I mean, obviously there's some that I don't like and they stay there forever. But now what I'm gonna do, because I found this kind of cool way of doing these swatches, I'm just gonna play around with my inks today. Yay! Oh, and these two little bottles here are the Troublemaker. See all that shimmer in there, all that gorgeousness. Yeah, these are the bottles that they're kind of plastic bottles that the Troublemaker inks come in, I should say. Very cute. Yeah, I will link that information in the description box below. All right, thank you very much. for watching and hanging out with me, and I will see you in my next one. Ciao, Ellie!